Narcissist, neglector, abuser. Who is that person in your life that you wish you had never met? Who is that person who is the bane of your existence? Who is that person that when you think about him or her, you find yourself going down into a dark place? Who is that person? If you have someone in your life like that, this video might help you get out of that dark place. Okay, remember, if you've seen any of these videos before, I'm always sharing about energy. We are energy, 100% energy. Our whole body is energy. We have an energetic field all around us. If you look at yourself in a very, very powerful microscope, you'll see that you're not solid. You are actually, there's a lot of space there. So the energy that you are emitting is the energy that you're attracting. That's what the law of attraction is all about. So remember, the law of attraction is you ask for something, you know it's already on its way, and you allow it. Now, the same holds true whether it's something that feels good or something that doesn't feel so good. So when we've got people in our life that are the bane of our existence, isn't it interesting how we might not be stopping to think about why we attracted these people into our life? Now, I know you're listening to this and you're probably saying, "What, Nancy, are you crazy? You don't know what that person put me through. There's no way I would have attracted that person into my life." But I'm here to let you know that subconsciously, yes, you did attract that person into your life. And here's the thing. As long as you are giving a label to that person, narcissist, abuser, neglector, alcoholic, gambler, whatever title, whatever label you are giving to that person, you are giving your attention, energy, and focus to that person. And remember, you have feelings attached to those labels. You have feelings attached to that person. So when you think about that person in the guise of the label you've given that person, your feelings are right there and you're like, ugh, and you're thinking about it and your thoughts are creating more negative thoughts and you are actually giving your power away to that person. Now, when you first learn this, it can be difficult because I remember when my teachers were telling me this and teaching me this, this is something that I resisted for many, many, many years because I just couldn't grasp it. I couldn't understand how I could attract something that didn't feel good into my life. How could I attract something that felt so horrible? But remember, you're not attracting the experience. You're attracting the feelings that the experience creates. Because we all come here with a karmic journey, a karmic contract. When our soul incarnates, we have a karmic contract. We say, this is what I'm going to do and be and have when I come into the world. But in order to fulfill that, we have to know opposite. We have to know contrast, right? You can't know light without dark. You can't know up if you don't know down. You can't know tall if you don't know short. So it's about the contrast. What is the contrast that we are experiencing so that we can recognize it, eliminate it, let it go, and move forward? This was probably the most valuable, lesson that I have ever learned. And when I truly, truly absorbed this understanding, when I truly got it, when I truly accepted it, when I truly took it into my very being, I couldn't believe how my life changed. Those people who I thought were there to victimize me, they held no power over me anymore. And that's when I truly, truly understood that being victimized does not make you a victim. So whoever these people are that are in your life, or maybe they're no longer in your life, but they're still in your life up here, right? Because you're thinking about them, and every single time you remember something from the past and it brings something up and it hijacks your emotions, hijacks your feelings, and you're like, oh, and then you're shooting all over yourself, right? I should have never met that person. I should have never gotten together with that person, whatever it is that you're telling yourself. And because in our minds, we judge ourselves. We say, if I had only done this, then I wouldn't have had that experience. But remember, you're here to experience everything that life has to offer. The contrast, the positive and the negative. There's no good or bad, right or wrong. There's simply contrast. It simply is. So what is coming into your life? Because whatever it is, you are attracting it. Whatever you're putting your attention, energy, and focus to, you are attracting those feelings to you. And if it's negative feelings that you're attracting, of course, you're going to experience something to create the negative feelings so that you can feel them. And until you're ready to actually recognize what it is and say, oh, okay, I get it. This feels like X. And then really sit with your feeling. Feel your feelings. Why do I feel this way? What's happening? What's going on with me? Why am I still giving my power to that person? What is it that I can learn or let go of and step into my power? Because we all have a tremendous inner strength. Every single one of us, we're born with that. It's inside of us. And you have the ability to tap into that inner strength at any given moment. And here's the thing. When you know how powerful you are, now you can say, all right, do I choose to use my power for me, for love of self, and raise my levels of self, my self-esteem, my self-worth, my self-image, my self-love, my self-confidence? Or do I choose to give it away? Do I choose to allow someone else to have that power over me and to lower my levels of self? Because remember, life is all about choices. If you have some challenges with someone in your life that you recognize you're still giving your power to, and you are really, really ready to let that go, I invite you to check out masteringyourbeliefs.com. Spend some time on the site. See what calls to you. And remember, if you have any questions on this, I'm here to serve and support you. I would love for you to have whatever it takes to let go of what no longer serves you and your highest self. And if you have any questions on anything, remember, ask your sensei. In the meantime, this is Nancy Muller, the one and only Life Sensei.